Hey, Jim, what's the name of those two guys down in Houston I was telling you who trashed me after I left?
Johnson and Walters, I think. Walters and Johnson.
What happened?
I was hyping my gigs in the Improv in Houston, and there's these two old guys. You walk in and...
Oh, yeah, we talked about that off air, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you remember that? This guy basically, he does all these voices.
Yeah.
And they sound exactly like he does like a black guy. So he'll be talking like, you know, you listen to Houston, blah, blah, and then it'll be like, to imitate the black guy, be like... Like, just like, oh, I didn't know that. Like, that's literally his impression.
That's the impression,
does, like, a girl.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, he's fucking horrific. But the thing is, you have to sit there and pretend...
That you like it.
No, that you're talking to that person. That it's different people.
Oh, you got to pretend that you're...
And his listeners...
Wait, he tells you, I'm going to do a lot of different characters?
No, the engineer goes in there and goes, yeah, don't... He does a bunch of different voices. Our listeners don't realize... That there's not a black guy, a woman,
a gay guy,
like all the hack fucking impressions.
And he does all of them.
And he does all of these.
Different people.
So I'm literally sitting there.
God.
It's this guy's like switching voices horrifically, horrifically right in front of him. I'm sitting there going like, this is the worst shit. And it's so awkward because you can't address it. And I don't know, I didn't have a good performance. But rather than them just going, hey, we don't think you're funny, they waited till I left.
Oh,
and then they just started trashing me, going, you know, a lot of times comedians come in, they're actually prepared, which I wasn't. But
you know what? How are you supposed to give an honest... Bill's the type of dude, like, in studio, you're not good at doing material in studio. He fucking hangs out, and he just riffs. And how are you going to riff when the guy you're supposed to riff with is being so dishonest?
Like, the first thing
I
would see...
The first thing I would see Bill doing is going, hey, why are you doing that? Why are you changing, like...
I was literally, that's all I could think of saying, like, dude, that is the worst impression of a black dude I ever heard.
Yeah.
You're horrific.
Yeah.
But I'm like, you know, I'm playing the game.
And
the numbers are low. I'm like, I got to sell the show. I'm spinning plates in there. I got those little 4th of July sparklers going over my head. So I fucking play the game, and then that's the greatest thing. Then I leave, and they trash me because I wasn't funny.
Oh. I did that show when I was in Houston. They had just come back on the air in Houston. And I was bombing so badly on that show, because, again, I won't go in and do material, that they actually played a fucking musical comedy CD.
While you were...
Well, they weren't dicks to me, to my knowledge. Like, I don't think they bashed me. No one ever told me they bashed. Well, I think someone would have said it.
I would have found out. Yeah, but, the pests are all-knowing.
I got... they were just... Awful. Awful. Older guy. There was no vibe in the room either. It was an empty studio.
How many real people are there?
Two.
Two.
Well, actually, none. I mean, just...
There's the two guy and, like, the, you know, you got the head guy.
The host.
And then the sidekick.
And then the guy that plays all the sidekicks.
And I'm telling you, the impressions are so bad. They are so fucking bad.
Really?
Oh, really? And then...
Oh, really?
My stars. Jesus.
Oh,
and the one guy has to fucking go look at the other guy doing these impressions. Hey, what's your problem there, Rufus? Or whatever the fucking awful black guy's name is.
Rufus.
It just stinks on ice. And I'm going to Houston, too. I just booked Houston. And I will not be doing that fucking radio show.
Why don't you do it?
Why don't you
do it and actually go on air?
Why are you doing the same fucking voices?
Why are
your listeners so stupid that they don't realize it?
Do you do the fake guy in the studio every day, sir? Do you do the fake black guy and woman and gay guy every day?
What the funny thing
is... Well, what you talking about? I'm right here.
As I found out, the way I found out, one of their listeners came up to me and told me that. And at that point, I snapped. Like, and I just went, do you realize that one guy's doing all those voices? And he's like, really? They don't even know.
Well, they will now.
Oh, please.
I say that the pests, if you know this show, should call it and call them out every time they pick up
every
the phone.
Every time. Just try to get out the fact that he's faking the
one
voices.
One guy is doing one all guy. Those voices.
Well, it says History of the Gods, as in G-A-W-D-S.
Thank God.
Gods. History of the Gods. The Walton and Johnson show is one of the most imitated and universally imitated radio programs in the nation.
Is it?
No show has a more unique mix of stream of consciousness.
Yeah, it is, because most shows suck.
Opinionated and compelling talk, guest musical elements, fictional characters and famous impersonations, great skit writing and production, coupled with powerful audience interaction, radio audiences seem to appreciate the effort. And yes, that was one sentence.
Hey, you know what's kind of cool, though? Even though, like, this is kind of good,
because it's a show that we're not going to like. Bill is yet again Rune the Bit Guy.
and I'm
for
happy
a show that we don't like.
But I didn't ruin. I've gone in there twice and sat there with like fucking blood coming
Why
out of my eye.
Why couldn't you Rune the Bit Guy when you were sitting there in front of him?
Yeah,
that's a good
Because you know
point.
What, you guys disguise your bits so well.
Oh, that's
I don't really
you,
understand.
Bill.
There
thank
you go. Hey,
thanks,
I'm
Bill.
Good. A little political.
That is a nice.
Hey, let's say hi to Chris in Houston.
That really would have been hilarious.
Here we go, Chris.
What's up, guys?
Hey, man.
Hey, you're talking about douchebag radio DJs. I fucking hate these guys that y'all are talking about. Y'all talking about Walton and Johnson, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, douchebags, douchebags, douchebags. May they die of AIDS.
He's got nothing.
All right.
I know.
Just call him up and just call him out.
Bone Spoon, you're on the Opie and Anthony show. What's up?
Hey, y'all want to hear what these dickholes sound like?
Yeah.
Oh, Walton Johnson.
Oh, they're fucking terrible.
Walton and Johnson.
That's here.
Yeah. All right, hold on.
Two, Risk Addiction, and that's the sequel to Basic Instinct 1, which you can call 1 because they didn't have 2.
That's one of
his
voices.
Have you looked at that?
I guess that is acting in a way.
Yeah.
Terry Bradshaw making it or not.
That
was just thinking about that. Terry Bradshaw, because I saw his ass. Just yeah. In fact, I saw him buck naked walking around just the other day.
And I'm afraid that really was...
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, because you saw it.
Is he the woman?
Everything. I know.
So he's doing that woman voice.
Yeah.
That is a disturbing. It will not leave your mind.
What are the black guy pipes in the voice?
He's just walking around feeding this fish naked.
I don't get it.
And not only that, it wasn't a fleet.
No, no, no.
Now he's talking in his regular voice.
It was lingering on my screen for 3 or 4 minutes. You know, that's what made it so funny is that it was. Constant. And he was so comfortable walking around naked like that.
Yeah, that bothered me a little bit.
And just not looking all that good walking around naked.
If you haven't seen this and now you're inspired to by this description.
Gay guy?
That one where...
Wait, he's doing the chick voice? That's a chick voice, right?
Matthew McConaughey won't move
gay
out
guy,
of his parents' house.
No, I can't tell.
Yeah, he's a gay guy.
Gay guy, okay.
Just like, it's just two guys... And one of them does three voices.
Yeah. She was in her first role since giving birth to our savior.
First role. I understand and feel Bill's pain.
Animated.
Holy crap.
I'll leave it on for a minute. I want to hear if he does the black guy voice.
Yeah. All right, hold on. Tigress. Jack Black voices the title character, which I could would be the panda bear.
I get very upset about these things because I want to be in them, and I didn't even know this was coming up. I didn't even know there was a shot.
The cast will also include Dustin Hoffman. Ian McCain from Deadwood, who plays that really mean, scary-looking guy.
I called Ari like 4 times last week, asked if I was in.
A woman.
Put me off, you know.
Yeah.
Jackie Chan and Lucy Liu will also be in the movie, but Walton Johnson will not.
Yeah.
June Allison has died. Famous actress way back in the day before she started wetting herself all the time.
You'd know her if you saw her on,
voice
TMC or...
Yeah, back in those old...
They're doing a Cheap Howard impression. I guess that's supposed to be Robin doing the...
Yeah.
As a pitch woman for Depends Adult Diapers.
Hey, you gotta work.
Yeah.
Even in your old age as an actress. There are very little jobs for old actresses.
She was 88 years old and had acute bronchitis and respiratory failure.
She always sounded like she had that earlier. She had that wispy kind of voice.
Come on, another voice. Do another voice.
Call some girls.
But this is the vibe of the show, and you walk in and you just,
wow. That's rough.
Girls. Yeah.
Just picture sitting there looking at this guy as he does these voices.
Jolene?
Yeah.
Jolene?
Trying not to spit in his face.
Me again. You called him before. I know, but I had to hang up real quick.
Yeah.
What I was trying to tell y'all was that I make it my everyday point to make sure that everybody that works with me at the fire department listens to y'all, including people that work in dozers like Todd Richard.
Bravo, go.
Are we
done?
Yeah.
This is really painful.
Sorry, boys. I got to get back to work.
All right, see ya. Thanks.
Thank you, Spoon.
I don't know. I don't hate the guy who does the voices as much as I fucking hate the guy who sits across from him, who actually looks at him and converses like he's three different people.
That looks like... That sounds like it's, like, way too much work.
Wow, right?
Why wouldn't you call him out on the air one day? You're pissed off at him.
Yeah.
A fucking phony.
Stop with your fake voice.
Oh, had I known that they were going to trash me the second I left?
Yeah,
absolutely.
You would have just unloaded.
Believe me, I regretted the fact that I didn't either.
Do they have some kind of a fail-safe? Where, like, because that could ruin everything.
There's got to be some sort of
There must be a delay where they could just dump go to commercials, and have the person killed.
Do we have a number? Do we have a number we can give out for that show? I'm sure they take phone calls.
Yeah, I would love for the pest to...
Hold on, Bill Burr. Bill!
Yo.
What's up, bro?
Hey, remember when I was making fun of those guys down in Houston?
Yes.
Yeah.
I did that radio show.
Walton and Johnson, I believe.
The guy, one guy does like three different voices and doesn't want anyone fessing up to the fact that he's also the black guy, the gay guy, and the woman. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I guess he heard me and Jim on whatever, us making fun of the show, so... One of them actually sent me a very heated email.
Oh, really?
Yeah, would you like me to read it?
I certainly would.
Hold on, I want to make sure the ONA pests are listening very very closely to Bill Burr.
Yes, pests, you are ready to be briefed.
Okay, Bill Burr?
All right, it said, okay, so he writes, first of all, the subject is international coverage for W&J. I don't know what the name of that. I don't know what their fucking name is.
Walton and Johnson.
Okay, there we go.
I think that's it.
Yeah. So he said, Richard Jenny has been on the show three times, Saget twice, Richard Lewis came back and did the show again the next day, liked it the first time. I guess it's because they were fucking funny. We have improv bookings on the show to help the club, not because we need or want your fabulous talent. Guess you queered that deal for them. I don't know what the fuck that means.
Queered the deal?
Here's the real irony, asshole. Do you get irony? Look up the XM numbers today. Assuming every goddamn receiver is on ONA, which ain't fucking likely, we have more listeners than they do. Way more.
Oh, boy.
So if you're ever in our flagship market again, Houston or Dallas, come see us again in person. We'll see if we can really get some bleeding from the eyes going.
I said I had blood.
So he goes, I did not grow up in any of those Eastern shitholes that is supposed to make you street tough, but I think I can hold my own.
Ew, that jerk off wants to have a fist fight? Are you going to fight in three different voices, you cocksmoker?
Oh, no, this guy.
I think he's going to come to me as the black guy.
He didn't say this stuff, did he?
Oh, wait a minute. It gets a little
You
bit
shouldn't
better.
Have smashed Bill when he left the studio, faggot.
Yeah.
He should have said it to my face.
Look, of course he should have.
I said I didn't have the greatest... But, dude, that's the second time I did that show.
Dude, do you realize what the pests are going to do to this show?
I have been waiting for a mission.
And by the way, I am booked in Houston, and I am booked in Dallas. I'll give you those dates later if Pete can give them to me. I'll tell you exactly when I'm in Houston and exactly when I'm in Dallas, and let's hope Club Soda Kenny's available.
Of course, to beat this guy up for you. You know what the pests hate even more than just people on the show being bashed? When they bring up all of their listeners, and we have more listeners than that. That gets the pest so fucking pissed, they will not leave this show alone.
Okay, well, this kind of really sent him over the top, because here comes the part about Jim.
Oh.
The part about Jim Norton? All right.
Yeah. He goes, if you ever bump into that bug-eyed fuck Norton, you can tell him not to worry. He won't never be allowed on anyway.
Good.
He is very humorous, but it's radio. Just looking funny doesn't count.
Just looking funny doesn't count.
Wait a minute, man. Ugh. Did they make fun of my appearance?
I didn't think he did.
Bill, let's go. All right, I give up. I apologize for that radio show.
Yeah, you better.
If you're going to start teasing my looks, well, that's going to be the end of this war. That's dirty pool.
All right.
Now, did I say that, or did the funny voice I make up say it? Fucking zeros.
Pest have been gunning for this. Oh, right. Dude, full attack mode.
All right,
full and complete attack mode, not partial. We're talking Israeli shit.
We got email addresses?
Wait, I got to read the last couple of lines.
So oh, there's more.
He ends it with, fuck you, coward. Gee, I hope we didn't burn any bridges here. And it's like, I wrote the guy back. It's like, dude, when I did your show, I wasn't rude or disrespectful to you. I was told not to address that you're doing three different characters. I didn't have a problem. I played along. I thanked him when I left. Then I go down to the improv, and I have five people come up to me and say, you know, you trashed me on the air after I left your show. When I couldn't defend myself, and you're calling me a coward. I basically said to the guy, all I did on the ONA show was the exact same thing you did in Houston, so stop being such a fucking baby about it.
You don't need to explain anything.
Did he get back to you?
No, I think he's doing his Tybo tape at this point, getting ready for me to come back again next June.
Well, I think they're on the radio right now, so let's get some numbers.
Come on, Who's got numbers? Let's get the phone numbers out there. A full attack. I want you guys to kill these motherfuckers
with your
calls and keep them from being able to take a telephone call. That's the best when they can't even plunk their own fucking phone lines down. We'll show them that we have no listeners.
Just call up and act like you're into the show, and then just try to see if you can somehow say on air that it's the same guy doing the show, doing all the characters, because evidently that's their big hook.
Bill, I think the pests know how they're to doing, be Bill. Pests. Yeah. That's why they're called pests.
The obvious.
I think they know. They get it.
What's the website again? Anybody know?
His email is jwalton10.
Well, email's one thing. We need phone number for the show.
jwalton10?
10, yeah.
Yeah, 10? At
Houston.rr.com.
Attack. No one treats our buddy Bill Burr like that.
That's right.
jwalton.
Bill bombs on this show all the time, and we never disrespect him.
No, you're doing it to my face.
Yeah, we get to make fun of his grandma, but no one else is allowed to make fun of Bill Burr.
I left the studio to talk about going down to my grandmother. He did it right in front of me.
Absolutely. How could I not with the fucking heart on my head?
jwalton10, Walton, W-A-L-T-O-N, jwalton10 at houston.rr.com.
Number 10, right?
Yes, the number 10. Bill Burr, the O&A Pest, had just been waiting for a mission.
What's the number? People have... They're putting phone numbers up on, like, Pal Talk and Instant Feedback. I'm not sure if they're right, though. We need confirmation before we go into attack mode.
Yeah, we'll get all the numbers out there.
Love a good battle.
Hey, how is our intelligence on this one? It's damn good.
Damn good. Confidence is high.
Yes. Bill Burr getting ready for the big gig in Boston, Comedy Connection, all weekend long. Headlining for the first time in his hometown.
That's cute.
All right, Bill.
I still think I can hold my own.
Oh, shut up.
My career's over. I pissed off Walter and Johnson.
Walton.
Walton.
Whatever.
I should hold my own. Maybe one of the other voices will pop out. You won't know who's holding what. It's like a big conglomerated mongrel studio full of people. That show fucking stinks.
I'm getting three different numbers here.
I'm going to have to take a karate class to handle multiple attackers when he comes at me with those three fucking voices.
Yeah, he's going to punch you. Who wrote you back? Was it the black guy or the guy?
Well, this is the funny thing. I don't know if it was the creep who's like the head guy or if it was the guy who does all the voices. I assumed it was the guy who did all the voices.
It's both. Now it's both will pay. Both will pay.
Well, here's some info. They call themselves the Radio Gawds, G-A-W-D-S.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do. Their phone number is 1-866-I-LOVE-W-J.
Ew.
The number's up on the pad data right now. 1-866-I-LOVE-W-J. W-J.
Oh, good. It's up on the... does Derek know how to spell W-J? You fucking dope.
Derek really is as dumb as they come.
We'll keep the number up there through the break. Oh, no, we can't really do that because of how things work. But,
son of a bitch.
Phone numbers.
Write it down.
1-866-I-LOVE-W-J. Let's see if they throw some of our callers on the air today.
And how about some Walton and Johnson fans? You guys want to call up and trash us? Feel free. Let them give out this number too, so they if they hear it, they can give this number out.
No,
if someone's in the area and they're on, we'd like to monitor the program.
Yeah, let's do that as well.
So get it on your radio, give us a call, and we'll listen on the phone.
I'm funny looking. I didn't think I was funny looking. That was hurtful and unnecessary.
He is humorous.
All I said was that your show is shit and you're a fraud because you do voices and expect a comic to have an honest interaction, and yet the whole thing you're doing is dishonest.
It's fake.
Well, it's a fucking phony nonsense.
Could you imagine? He basically ended his email with that old vaudeville joke. Hey, kid, you got a great face for radio.
Yeah. Oh, God. Yeah, that really is awful.
Wah, wah, wah.
Norton's really funny. Dot, dot, dot. Looking. Spelled L-O-O-K-I-N with the little apostrophe after the N.
Oh, God.
You fucking dope.
We love beating up our own, but no one else is allowed to beat up our own.
Hey, this is not Jim talking. This is the other black guy talking. You can't mess with my friend.
Oh, dear, you shouldn't mess with him. That wasn't me. That was a black guy and a lady. My God, we got a whole full crew here. The fucking nerve of you to expect a comic to sit there and fucking play along with that shit.
Wow. Drivel. Imagine having to sit and fucking play to one guy that's making like he's three and don't let the secret out.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Oh, it's just between us.
The first thing you'd have to say is, why are you doing that?
Hush, hush.
Stop it.
Hush, hush. Tee-hee-hee, it's between us. Tee-hee-hee.
The only time you should be doing that is if you're holding a puppet and calling an old lady a cunt.
That's right.
The only time that works.
But at least if there was a puppet, I'd have something to look at instead of looking at this. But even then, man, I'm not making excuses because I definitely, that wasn't a great appearance on that fucking show. But if you're going to trash me, do it to me. Don't be like smiling, hey, thanks for coming in, and then let me fucking leave, and then you open your big fat.
And they were the ones, yeah, they drew first blood.
And dude, I will also acknowledge I did not have a great appearance at all on their show. And it's okay, I've had bad appearances before, but I will throw myself under the bus, but I will drag the 40 people in that studio, oh wait, it's just two, and say that the fucking vibe, it was like, they're like, hey man, we just went back on the air, we know you're on XM. They just come back into Houston, they're paranoid, and there was no, they don't even look at you. They don't even look at you. It was two fucking older gentlemen looking at each other, and you're in the fucking side piping, and it was fucking horrendous.
Here we go. Wes in Houston.
Hey, watch
Wes.
Watch them out, Jim. They might want to beat you up, too.
I know. I don't want to get beat up, because I'm funny looking. Oh, go ahead, Wes.
All right, let's listen to Wes from Houston. Wes?
Yeah. I'm here.
Hi, Wes.
You got him on?
You all ready?
Yeah, let's hear.
Hold on. We need to see this capture. We need to record it. Thanks, buddy. Yeah. It's a good start. I like people that are at least thinking
fucking
outside the box.
Banjo,
I'm thinking about becoming
fucking
a
Jew haters.
Can y'all hear that okay?
Yeah, keep it going. Just leave it there.
Security benefits. I don't have to worry about the IRS dogging me all the time because I'm not even a citizen. I can still vote in all the elections.
Sure.
I can still get free health care down at the emergency room. I can still send my kids to the school.
Trash.
Boring.
Pretty damn good plan. Not being a citizen.
Take a call.
Yeah,
take a call.
You can really get decent health coverage now when you go to the hospital.
That's a guy doing the chick's voice. Or is that the gay voice? We don't know.
Oh, God. It's much better if they find out that you have no.
It doesn't even sound like a chick. It sounds like him, like a little higher.
Sounds like Dustin Hoffman in Tootsie.
Yeah. I wish he'd have a breakdown and as the black guy shoot everybody.
Yeah.
But I got a real problem there, Billy. Ed, I go to a lot of trouble to wax my mustache. You know, it's a good-looking, big, old, thick mustache.
Fucking hayseeds.
Oh, my God.
All these guys are coming up to me and saying, man, that is a badass mustache.
Oh, hey, you guys, follow that.
Follow that, he says to us.
You guys think you can follow that, Heath?
I don't know. They're bringing it.
I would be a little concerned about how many men are coming up to you hitting on you. I do. I will say this. The mustache is not nearly as popular with the women as it was several years ago. The women today are going, like the men, are preferring shaved.
Yeah, you know what? And I haven't seen you and your mustache, but I just haven't.
You're not a woman, you're a guy!
Faggot!
That was the female voice or the gay voice?
I don't even know. Well, it sounds like there's a whole bunch of people in that studio.
Certainly does.
That's not a good thing.
You look like a porn star or...
I liked this show when it was called Phil Hendry.
You're not a woman, you're a guy.
Curl it up on the end a little bit. See?
Phil Hendry's brilliant when he does it. You guys stink.
Twist it into the tips of your stash.
The stash.
Head up.
Backwards douchebags.
All the pests are now organizing. We're seeing they're putting out the website where they're streaming the show so they could listen to it live as they then see when they take some phone calls and get in there.
We're going to need someone to tape, you know.
I'm sure it's happening.
All right,
these guys have battle stations. They know exactly what to do, where to go.
Yeah.
They record it.
They completely turned it over to...
I'm sure the screener is going fucking bullshit.
They're still over in Afghanistan.
Oh, okay.
Please do the black guy character. This is the one.
What the fuck are you talking about?
We want the black guy character.
Yeah, I want to hear the black guy character. Maybe he took the day off.
Lazy fuck. He's late.
I'm not going with that.
Guys,
he was arrested for raping the white character.
Huh?
do y'all want me to call back when the clones start, when they...
Yeah, definitely.
Yes.
Because we can't listen to that drivel.
I'll call you back then. I can't handle listening
dribble.
To too much.
No, it's
more.
Awful.
All right,
never.
Just sit there and have a few laughs.
All right.
Those guys are tough.
Let's say hi to Chris in Houston. Chris, what's up?
What's up, boys?
Hey.
Hey, about the Super Bowl that happened in 2004 here in Houston, Jay Moore had a problem with him as well.
What was the problem?
Who's Jay Moore?
He said that he wasn't being funny enough for them, and you know, same shit that they did.
Their favorite movie is Hooper. Stupid fucking Hicks.
Hooper. Wow.
Yeah. All right,
Chris. Thanks, man.
It sounds like it's a bad vibe to do comedy.
When I first came in, it was just the vibe was awful. And again, I'm certainly not saying I was great. I'll be honest. I know what I'm good.
You
I know what
are
I
great.
Stink.
Shut up.
Yeah, right. I was good. They didn't get it. LOL. No, I was mediocre at best, kind of bordering on shitty. Oh. But just the vibe in there stunk, and the fact they would trash Bill.
Yeah.
We don't have him on because we need comedians on. We're doing a favor for the club. Are you really? So you have all these millions of listeners, and you're throwing bad comedians on as a favor to the improv, you fucking liars?
Wow. And that just goes to show you, like, Bill's one of those guys that could just come in, hang out, and bullshit about whatever's going on and stuff like that. You know, they probably want, you know, pieces of people's act.
All right, here we go. We got
you know?
I don't want to do my act, but like I said, I don't mind. You trash him. Just do it when I'm there. It would have been funny. Cause
it's a punk move.
Like, you know, but don't... They was serious, like, don't go see this guy kind of shit that they were saying. At that point, it's like, you know, you're fucking with my show at that point, and that goes beyond just, you know, busting balls.
Fucking with your livelihood. Let's say hi to Gary and Dallas. He has background on them.
Taking food out of my children's mouths.
Hey, that's my bread and butter.
Hey, how about I go to
Gary?
Hey, guys. All right, they came here in the about 84, lasted for about a year and a half from New Orleans. Got kicked off the radio and sent back down to New Orleans. Their ratings were never anything. So here they are trying to make it back to Dallas again. Didn't even know they were back. When I drive to work every day, all I see are ONA signs all over town. You guys rock.
Oh, thank you, guys.
So they're on in the morning in Dallas, too, right?
We're barely on in the morning in Dallas.
They are. Yeah, that will change.
Have a chicken fried steak and drag the nigga character from the back of a pickup truck, you fucking Jew haters. .com.
Otto and George. Hey, Bill, thank you so much.
All right, not a problem.
Enjoy the Comedy Connection this weekend in Boston.
All right, guys, I'll see you next week.
All right, good. Bill Burr, everyone.
We'll take care of the situation. The pest will.
It's a battle stations.
Yeah.
All right, let's say hi to Lee in Michigan. Lee.
Hey.
Hi, Lee.
I just thought I would give y'all a holler and let y'all know since y'all gave out that number. I've been trying to call that stupid-ass show, and I can't get through.
I imagine that they're going to be getting a few phone calls.
Yes, just a few, with the no listeners that we have.
I like to sit down to a chicken-fried steak and my favorite movie, Stroke of Race.
All right, thank you.
Reset your...
That's a funny movie.
Oh, really fast. Doug Stanhope gave us a little plug on his latest CD.
He did.
He's only been on our show once. We love Doug Stanhope. We got to get him on...
Doug's a good boy.
A little more often, but...
a great drug story.
This is what he had to say off his latest CD.
God, I got a designated drinker. Could you can half of that for me, Captain? Oh, you're the Opie and Anthony guy. You're the worst. No. Opie and Anthony and Stern, I love. It's the fucking noodle heads who act. Everything has to be about fuck Stern, Opie and Anthony, fuck Opie and Anthony. They're ripoffs of Stern. They're both fucking good, and they're bringing a medium that's actually getting me recognized to light. If you don't have a fucking satellite radio, get it. Don't listen to this fucking dipshit and shithead in the morning. They're both good. Opie and Anthony, good. What?
And you got the name. You got the name wrong. It was Walton and Johnson.
Yeah. Why did he have to throw in Stern to ruin the plug for the moment?
Man.
Fucking jerk.
He's got to cover all his bases.
Bastard. I know. You know how comedians are.
Speaking of Walton and Johnson, we got some of their bits, everybody.
They call
themselves the Radio Gwad.
G-A-W-D, because that's how you say it.
Isn't that such a cool way to say it?
Those
guys are good.
His shit is great. All right, here we go. Walton and Johnson. Some of their bits.
T.O.'s audiobook. Terrell Owens, I believe, yes?
Uh-huh.
So they got a little bit called T.O.'s audiobook.
Okay.
Walton and Johnson, everybody.
This is probably the black guy character, by the way.
Oh, good. I want to hear that one.
Yeah.
Get a nigger puppet.
It's not going to surprise me if this is the black guy character.
Oh, yeah. No.
Oh, boy.
It's not working.
Why would it work?
Fans up, though. I don't know what I'm doing.
You belong in this.
Is it stuck?
Oh, no.
Nazi.
Oh, no. I told you to leave it alone. It's a very important work of art.
I think E-Rock's pretty good at... E-Rock! Matt in Queensbury.
Good evening.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
I'm using you to stall. Go.
Just want to let you know that since you gave out the number to the Masters and Johnson there, it was like 10 minutes ago or whatever.
Yeah.
I've called that nonstop, and it's been that circuit overload busy.
Mm.
Yeah.
So they're definitely getting bombarded by the...
I bet they're not acknowledging it either.
And this is a lot different than other radio shows. We will not stop.
No, this will just keep going and going. And even if the callers don't get through, a few will, believe me, but even if they don't, you take... their calls out of the mix. Now they got to sit do a show.
And also, this phone screener is very unhappy.
Oh, I don't doubt it.
You guys are the Beatles, and they're the fucking Dave Clark Five, so fuck Houston.
They had a couple of hits.
Thank you, Otto. All right, here we go. So it's T.O.'s audiobook.
Which one am I? I don't want to be Harrison. He had a little thing under his hat.
Old pudding head. Thing under his hat?
Yeah, brain cancer.
Oh, jeez.
You're the...
There's no boundaries with you guys. You're so wacky.
Oh, stop me before I... Stop me!
Here we go.
That's the gay character.
I don't want to be the one that fucks old popsicle stick leg either.
That's true. Or the one that stops to sign everything thrown in front of him. I just want to be the shit dick drummer. That's who I want to be.
Oh, God.
Language, young man. This is my home.
My new book by Terrell Owens.
Oh, God.
In the beginning, God created T.O. because the rest of the world was void and without form and without the best receiver in NFL history. And God saw that T.O. was good, real damn good.
Oh,
and on the seventh day, he rested.
Nice production value.
Because he got tired of chasing T.O. into the end zone. And T.O. got so fast that when he ran at full speed, he was traveling in time.
Boring.
And he was able to score points in games that had already been played. In fact, if you look at pictures of Super Bowl I,
isn't
you see
just
T.O. standing
Norris
next to Vince Lombardi telling him,
awful.
I got to get my dollars up, bitch. And then one day, T.O. run right off the face of the earth and scored points in space. And got signed by an advanced race
turn
of alien people who didn't have a quarterback that could get T.O. One day in the distant future, scholars would remember T.O. as one of them Greek mystological figures. Run real fast,
my favorite coming up.
And T.O. promised to return one day, bringing the people of the earth peace, love, joy, and a whole bunch of T-shirts available at TerrellOwens.com. I love myself!
Oh, Jesus.
I don't know how we compete against this.
I see the awful, terrible things in my life and turn it into something funny.
Do ya?
Oh, that was fucking an abomination.
Yeah. Oh. Ma, please stop calling me.
You can act like a man. What's the matter with you?
Oh,
come on.
I'm not going to lower it. I have to do this now.
And a man in my position can't afford to be made to look ridiculous.
Great.
Oh,
what was
let me tell you something, my crunk Mick friend.
Excuse me, I'm not German Irish. I'm a black white female gay.
God.
We might have got our first one through.
Oh, nice.
Let's go to Jeff in Texas. Jeff.
Hey, boys.
Hey. Hi, Jeff.
Hey, what's going on?
Go ahead.
Hey, I got the Walton Johnson show on. Someone just wished Jimmy a happy birthday.
They wished me a happy birthday. Thank you.
I laughed so hard I had to stop my tractor.
Stupid ass.
Get out of Malinga.
Go home and get your fucking shine box.
Well, right away.
He's just getting a little fucking manners. Hey. I'm breaking your balls, and right away you're getting fucking fresh.
Fucking fresh.
Let's go to Mark in Connecticut.
Fresh.
Mark.
Fresh.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Great.
Let's go, Mark.
My wife got through.
Yeah.
And they said, oh, yeah, you sound like you're from up north. What are you, another O&A fan? Clicked, hung up the phone.
Wow.
Good. Hey, they put the challenge out
there. You sound like you're from up north.
Yeah.
Getting through true. So.
All right, thank you. Let's go to
That's
Jason
cool.
in Houston.
I bet you like the colored folk, too, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, they, somebody called in wishing Jimmy a happy birthday.
Thank
yeah.
you.
I was Today's pretty happy birthday. About that.
Right.
And then they started bragging about, oh, we've got a dump button. You probably don't know that. So
yeah, we'll tie that. We'll tie that dump button up the whole show, asshole.
Real brave. Yeah, so they put out the challenge. Real brave.
We are not going to dump out of any Walton and Johnson callers. You call up and you want to trash us because you like that show, fine. No one is going to dump out.
We're the Israel of radio.
That's right. Right. We're not tough, but we are Jewish.
You guys were Sex for Sam, and that was really stupid, and they really made note of that. So.
Yeah. Oh, really? Wow, this guy's really... That's fucking good.
Wait, what did they say?
They made note of how stupid Sex for Sam was, and that I'm ugly. Boy, they really hit below the belt.
Wow.
Yeah. How do they find these inside facts out?
Yes. I like brain cancer.
Yeah, Sex for Sam was really stupid. It made us multimillionaires. Yeah.
Why don't you fuck... Did it?
Yeah.
That's terrible. I'm sorry.
Multimillionaire? Wait a minute.
I mean,
I didn't know. You said, no, you said millionaires, and I remember we were all talking, and you're like, no, three ways, all for one, one for all.
Here we go, Andy in Texas. Andy.
Yeah.
What's up?
Hello.
Yes, you're on the phone, mister.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
I'm the one that got through first on the Wallace and Johnson, or Walton and Johnson show.
Yeah.
What about them?
Yeah, I wish little Jimmy happy birthday, and I got in at, I was in Dallas and saw this play, three rights make a left, and saw little Jimmy Norton.
Oh, if that was you, man, thanks a lot.
Thanks, Andy.
All right.
You're a good boy.
See, these guys love this shit.
It's what they do.
They won't stop. It's all they do.
They're jobless animals.
Hey, you want to hear another bit from the Walton and Johnson show?
I don't know. Let me sit down first because I doubled over laughing so hard. I almost fell.
Put on your laughing hats. It's a song parody.
Oh, no.
Oh, great.
How do you stop laughing?
It's so overproduced and unfunny. It's just, it's unintelligible.
A song parody.
Well, maybe you didn't hear the part where T.O. went into space and scored points out there. Oh. I had quite a laugh at that because there's nothing in space.
Oh, God.
That is funny.
Song parody of Paperback Writer.
Oh.
Changing the words to mean immigrant driver.
About as funny as a wheelchair ramp. Fucking suck.
No. Laugh.com. Get your Otto and George CDs.
Otto is the fucking funniest guy ever.
Immigrant driver.
Oh, I'm already douche chilling.
This is terrible.
This sucks.
He's got no license, couldn't read the book. Now watch him take a turn and never take a look.
Shut up.
He came from Asia or from Mexico. Now he's got a car but not a residence. Immigrant driver.
Stop it! Stop it!
Immigrant driver.
Stop it!
You stick.
Would you kindly shut your noise hole?
Those guys are bad.
Excuse me, but I do believe that's some ass.
Stop whining. Stop whining.
Are you fucking with me?
That's terrible. I'm sorry. That's terrible. I'm sorry.
Oh, my throat hurts.
Ugh, all right.
Yeah.
It's fucking on and awful. On.
Jesus.
Let's say hi to Nicole in Houston.
He does these impersonations. I swear, you would think it was the real people.
Oh, you're all the same guy. Fucking zilch. It's the board op, too. The same guy.
We woke up Houston today. Nicole in Houston, what's up?
Well, I just called through, and they asked who I was calling from, and I said Houston. They said, we're not letting anybody else through because of the Opie and Anthony show.
Of course. There you go. There's your brave radio.
There's your brave radio. We have no listeners.
Radio gods.
The radio gods.
They're the brave radio gods.
Hey, Jimmy.
Yes, miss?
I just bought tickets to your show, and I'm super excited.
Ooh. Thank you. I wish I was. Stan, what are the dates?
August
17th through the 19th. August 17th through 19th. I'm at the Houston Improv. Let's get a number and get this rolling. August.
Yes.
Well, they better not come for Houston. Why? What are you going to do, stupid? You going to show up and blow me while I'm selling merchandise? Fuck yourself.
Rick from Houston. Rick.
Hey, y'all quit fucking calling the goddamn show down there. Y'all fucking shit up. I can't get through or nothing. Y'all just screwing a good thing up.
Oh, yeah? You're lying.
What good thing?
We could tell you're a fan of the show.
Yeah, that was awful.
Bastard.
Y'all screwing a good thing up.
Surgery. Surgery.
Sugary.
Hi, Sugary.
Sugary.
Hey, hi, Sugary.
I listen to him in the morning instead of you guys.
Okay.
Yeah. XM Satellite Radio, I listen to him afterwards, and the reasons are, Opie, you're an ass.
Thank you.
Anthony, uh-huh. You got a pretty level head. And Jimmy, you're going to be at Zany's in Tennessee, 21st, 22nd.
See, we want a real...
No, he gave the dates wrong, you little bastard. It's 27th through 29th of July. Oh, what's that for, you bastard?
Jeff in Houston. Jeff.
Hey, guys.
What's up, Jeff?
I don't know why you think those bits aren't funny.
All right. Elvis.
No.
We really want to find someone.
I don't know why I don't think they're not funny.
That was fucking Kevin Bacon from JFK. You're a handsome man, Mr. Walton. You're not a bad looking man, Mr. Johnson.
Time for another Baggots. Walton and Johnson bit.
Oh,
yeah, come
on. Pull over, folks. Laughs are coming.
I don't know why we do this. I don't know why we help another show like this by playing their bits and showing people how great they are.
Because the bits are terrific. This is called Pimp the Hose.
Pimp the Hose. I bet the black guy shows up.
Oh, my. He does the T.O. song, too. This guy doesn't stop.
Song parody of Barry Manilow song.
Oh, my goodness. This is going to be a gem. I can sense it.
Goddamn rich cunt.
Let's go to Theo in Virginia. Theo.
Hey, what's up?
What's up,
Hi, Theo.
I got through for a second. I don't think it was on air. I think they're in a commercial or something.
Yeah.
But the guy's like, you guys can stop calling. You don't think you're going to break us, do you? And his voice all cracked. And
out. Yeah. Great.
Yeah, wait till it starts again tomorrow and then Monday. You geese.
I think the whole month of July should just be punished, these guys.
But they trashed Bill when he left. And that's the bottom line. They have more listeners than the Opie and Anthony show. And they insulted my appearance. And as we all know, I happen to be damn cute.
All right. Thank you, Theo.
Bug-eyed and ugly. Right. That was
uncalled
for.
They have no idea what they started.
And hurtful.
Here's Pimp the Hose. Oh, no.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
God.
You know they're going to go all the way to the end of this song.
Yeah, it's going to be the whole song.
Yeah, not even
it's
just
like
a
20-minute song.
In the hood forever. And I smoked the very first crack.
Oh, no.
I put the cane and the baking soda together. I'm a wigger and I pimp the hose.
What?
I pimp the hose and wear some booyah bling. I murk fools cause you
I can't even comment on this.
Bunnies too. I pimp the hose, I pimp the hose.
Do ya?
Oh, my shorties reach in your pants.
Oh.
Wear a Jimmy hat, don't take a chance. And I got some three ways if you can pay.
It's over, Johnny.
Gold teeth, fill up.
You're just a tool.
An extra 50 you can take or sell. They do me, they do you, they do you, they do me. It's an urban orgy.
Ah!
I pimp the hose and wear some booyah bling.
So it's good to repeat things in song parody.
Are
we done with this?
No! I'm trying to have a laugh.
Bunnies too.
Tell him, Fred.
I pimp the hose, I pimp the hose.
This is just punishment. This is just punishment now.
I pimp the hose and wear some booyah bling. I murk fools
You better get your head and your ass wired together, or I will take a giant shit on you. What's that supposed to be, some kind of sick joke?
You ever suck a guy's cock? Show me how you suck a guy's cock. So show me with your mouth. Show me with your mouth.
I tried to do it.
I'm a wigger and I pimp a
hoe. Do you want to kiss me or can I kiss you on the mouth?
Hello, exactly. We look like assholes right now, man.
Well, the phones are coming in like crazy. Danny in Texas. Danny.
What's up? Hey.
Welcome aboard, Dan.
I got through for like 3 seconds, and the only thing I got to say was, you sure have got a pretty mouth, and then they hung up on me.
Houston
Improv, since they challenge anyone to come down, August 17th through 19th, I will be there. August 17th through 19th, here's the number, 713-333-8800,
713-333-8800. Well, no shit.
August 17th through 19th. August.
Well, how about pediatric theater, guys?
What's that?
This will be the last Walton and Johnson bit.
We don't want to promote these guys.
These were posted on their website, so they were very proud of these bits.
This is like the best of the best.
Cream of the crop, as it were.
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, look at this. This threat. Bill in Houston. We heard them all before, boys. Bill.
Yeah, they just called the Wallace and Gromit show and they said they're going to start tracing our phone calls.
Ew.
These zilches mean shit.
Let me tell you something.
I'm out.
Here's the word of advice. If you're a radio show and you're trying to be funny and you have to resort to using the FBI, you're not a funny radio
show.
We're
going to report you. There's nothing a station can do if people are calling their line to get through. Do you know there's nothing they can do?
Yeah. It's a public station.
The pests already know that.
The pests know all the rules. They laugh at that.
We got
they
lawyers throwing a pests.
Yeah.
Wow.
That help out the other pests.
One of our biggest pests is an ex-police officer slash fucking psychopath.
Well, one more bit from these wonderful.
Why are we promoting the competition, Opie? They're going to get millions of listeners from this.
This is called the movie game with kids.
Oh, God. I need Strychnine. It's another one all the way through.
No, I was talking about a past night.
Wow. Are you still here?
Yeah.
Are you growing your mustache back?
Yeah.
I see a little stubble.
No, don't grow it back.
You don't.
No, grow it back.
No, Anthony doesn't care about your life.
Without the mustache, it looks like a half a honeydew melon.
All right. I'll try to please everyone.
Your job is to be intimidating.
Yeah.
You don't look as intimidating without that dopey cop mustache.
Really?
You look kissable. Yeah.
unless, like I said, a Hitler mustache.
All right, we'll work it out.
Bring that look back.
Really?
Yeah.
Kenny, I got a job for you.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
The slum landlord has finally made contact.
Don't kill him.
Can you... Here.
Give it to a Jew congressman in another district. Not our chinless cop.
He will pick up if you use my phone.
We know cops without chins, right, dirty cops.
Go.
All right. Crooked cop. Crooked
guys,
cop.
The movie
that
game.
Tell dirty jokes.
The movie game. And by the way, Kenny, I'm not talking to him. I'm busy all day.
The voicemail.
Figures.
Maybe he's calling his lawyers because he's scared. Maybe he's calling
voicemail
the Walton and Johnson show.
Just say glub, glub, glub into his voicemail.
Yeah.
It's some company.
Yeah. All right, listen, here's the pediatric theater, the movie game with kids.
You're through. Well, let me retort. Could you describe for me what Marcellus Wallace looks like? What country are you from?
What?
What ain't no country I know. Do they speak English and what?
What?
English, motherfucker. Do you speak it?
Yes.
Then you understand what I'm saying.
Yes.
Now describe what Marcellus Wallace looks like.
What?
Say what again?
Say what again? I dare you.
I don't dare you, motherfucker. Say what one more time.
That kid's cursing is funny.
Now describe to me what Marcellus Wallace looks like.
Well, he's black.
Go on.
And he's tall.
Does he look like a b***?
No.
Then why are you trying to f*** him?
Like a b***?
I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Yes, you did, Brett. You tried to f*** him.
You ever read the Bible, Brett? Yes. There's a passage.
These guys know nothing about editing. You know, just we get it. Just stop.
Yeah. It goes on for another 2 minutes.
We know the scene.
Another 2 minutes?
Actually, that could have worked.
The last for a second, but not the whole fucking movie.
Yeah,
you know?
Kids are cursing. It's a good scene in a movie that everybody likes. So it's got all the features, but they just don't. They fucking drill it into the ground. And then what was it with all the smashing shit? That scene was quiet. Up until it blew his fucking head off.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have not heard from him in quite a while. It's Dugout Doug.
Hi, Doug.
Hi, everybody.
Hey, hi. Doug.
We'll have a Pal Talk room set up at 5:30 tomorrow morning, and we'll be streaming their show so everybody can partake in what we like to call an attack.
They're an hour behind us, though.
What's that?
I think they're an hour behind, right?
An hour behind?
So what time is it? So it's 5:30 Eastern, I believe.
Which would be 4:30 there.
That'll be 4:30 their time.
That's 4:30 their time, Doug.
All right. Let's do math.
That's great. The best war room, the general. Synchronize your watches, idiot. Yeah.
As they sit there and wait for an hour and a half.
I know. Doug's just yelling, I want that whole goddamn tree line bomb.
It'll be fun just listening to the overnight jock just babble about nothing.
Want you to put that pontoon up our ass. Just
we'll
the flare.
We'll have to figure out a way to get the FM people in on this.
Yeah, we'll talk about it tomorrow morning, believe me. It's 6:30 you should start, because I think that's 5:30 in Houston.
Yeah, remind us tomorrow, Doug. You can call the other show, and we'll get the other side of the show involved, too.
Hang on a second. Was I right with the 5:30?
I don't know.
5:30 would be 4:30
5:30
Houston,
here is 4:30 there.
They're an hour behind.
Wednesday is Sunday.
That's right.
At Carvel. Thinny Thin. Your fatty fat friends.
Phyllis Diller is Bo Derek.
Let's say hi to John.
Mudgee the Whale.
Yeah, fudge.
John?
Hey, how's it going?
What's up, John?
Hi.
Hey, I just heard my radio show down here. What's going on with you guys? Why you guys got to keep calling and screwing with these folks?
Folks. They suck. That's why.
Folks. Folks.
Well, I've been listening to these guys for a long time.
Put your head under a fucking tractor wheel then.
Yeah, well, you can tell your fucking Dugout Doug. If he wants to talk, he can see me at Norton's show on August 17th at 8:30.
Your mother's cunt then. Your mother's cunt.
Thank you, mister.
We need people that really hate us.
Hey, dude, if he wants to talk about August 17th through 19th, me at the Houston Improv, then that boy can do so.
Oh, your mother's cunt.
Let's hear somebody endorsing Jim.
He stinks, and I don't like him. I don't like to insult me.
All right, Doug, you're getting organized.
We are getting organized. We've got, I believe he was trying to sell something on the internet, one of the two, and we've got his home number also. We're getting all the information together.
Oh, no.
418.com attack forum. There's a thread going on Whackbag for it. So everybody's getting together, and we're all going to meet tomorrow morning in a Pal Talk room and stream the show and dial the phone.
Now,
and
Doug,
find message boards.
Doug, remember, keep everything legal, yet make it as annoying as is humanly possible for that show.
Oh, definitely. I just hope nobody swears on the air and makes them run out of dump or anything like that.
We wouldn't want that.
Yeah. Oh, we would.
No profanity.
We wouldn't want that.
You know, like, you never want to start and go, look, I really love you guys. Cunt, because they have to dump out and it's ruined.
By the way, they're on 5:30 to 10 Central Time.
So we'll have some maps ready so you can call from a local area. And don't forget about the spoof tells so we can get around the phone screeners if they have any caller ID. We got everything set up. It's all set.
You have a way to spoof it so it looks like you're calling from Houston?
Yes.
Jesus.
Yeah, they know how to believe me. Wow. What's going on over there is...
It's fucking NORAD.
It really is.
Just unplug the goddamn thing.
Close down the mountain.
We haven't done anything for a while.
I know. We saw you chomping at the bit on the message board, so we're ready to rock on these guys. Assholes.
We've been kind of hanging out, letting you guys get the FM thing going, and then we just want to strike and make ourselves look good.
Hope they're not getting all fat. Hope you've been keeping trained. Got to have our troops in training all the time.
That's right.
All right.
Actually, they have to stay fat. That's just what they are. They're all fat.
They're all messes.
Big fat
Thanks,
messes.
Man. Right now, fucking Bam is taking his Dockers out. I want to fucking just throw cow's blood on those Dockers and watch it fucking roll right off. Fucking Bam wears stain-free slacks.
Marty in South Dakota.
Where is he?
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hey, Marty.
Hey, man.
You know, I can't figure it out, man. How long you guys been at this shit? For a long time, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And these fucking idiots at these other radio stations can't figure out how many listeners you guys have, and that they challenge you, they're going to get fucked.
Yeah, I mean, come on, how stupid are they?
Well, we'll find out how stupid they are.
I just hope that they don't start whipping out the voices, because that's when the show gets good.
Yeah. Oh, God, you know, I was laying down, I'm a truck driver and shit, and these guys started putting that shit on, I thought I was going to fucking have to go hang my head out the door and vomit.
Wow.
And playing that stupid last song.
It really was awful.
It was.
That Barry Manilow song took years off my life.
Awful, wasn't it?
Years.
Just horrid. And I apologize to the audience, but sometimes you have to be subjected to the things that are this horrid.
Fucking painfully unfunny.
All right, Walton and Johnson, some of the pests got through. Here's the first caller.
Get a couple of calls in before the hard break here. Because Andy's been on hold for a while. Yeah, go ahead, Andy.
Yeah, I was wondering if y'all saw that show in Dallas. I think y'all from Houston, though, right?
Well, we're from Houston. We've been everywhere.
Okay, you got this show in Dallas called Three Rights Make a Left. I Want to Go Home. Starring that comedian, Little Jimmy Norton. He's a funny guy. He's happy birthday, Jimmy. Watch it out.
All right, Ian, I hadn't seen it, but it sounds good.
Three Rights Make a Left. I Want to Go Home.
I Want to Go Home.
Okay.
References to
the
show.
To each his own.
They have no clue what it means.
Johnny, hey, how you guys doing?
You're Johnny. We're Walton
Johnson.
What an
asshole, okay. Wow. Oh, they are out of practice. Yeah. You dumb motherfucker.
You rusty pest.
He gives him a fake name. Johnny? Who's John? Oh, I'm Johnny, yes. Joe, Johnny.
I'm your friend Shirley.
What?
Hey, get a load of fesso over there.
Hey, get a load of black-white gay woman.
Fucking fraud.
What an idiot. He forgot his name was Johnny.
Johnny. Don't fool for that old gag.
Johnny. You goose.
It's like the old Great Escape scene. Have a nice day. Oh, thank you.
Oh fuck. We got him on the bus.
Avalanche.
God.
We got to give the ONA pest some missions every once in a while to keep them.
Yeah.
Come on. Get him training, sharp. Guys. And to come up with a fake name, remember it.
This is like Stripes. Then again, maybe one of us won't.
Here it is again.
Sure.
Johnny?
Johnny, hey, how you guys doing?
Yeah, you're Johnny. We're Walton.
Bad espionage.
Dumb fuck.
Wow.
Yeah, he really is a bad spy. What are you doing here? Well, I'm not spying. Oh, okay.
It's over, Johnny.
Johnny.
It certainly is. Johnny?
Johnny Cakes.
God.
Johnny?
Johnny, hey, how you guys doing?
What's going? You're Johnny. We're Walton and Johnson Show.
Yes, hello, Johnny.
How you guys doing?
What's on your mind, buddy?
Tell you what, ask me how I'm doing one more damn time.
It's one of those guys from that stupid cable show. They're putting their people out there.
Yeah. Why are they so concerned with us? We must be bothering them and getting on their mind.
Well, we have more listeners than they do. Yeah. I looked at the numbers on X.
Holy crap. They're just clinging to a fucking lie, aren't they?
Yeah.
Which is horrible.
They don't have more listeners than us.
I looked at the numbers.
They want to ignore
the numbers.
They want to ignore that we're on. How many commercial stations?
I don't even know anymore.
Including
announcements coming out of stations. I don't even know if yet.
By the way,
the amount of people listening to us just on commercial radio in New York City.
In New York,
beats them.
Yeah,
beats them right there.
Then you add XM. Then you add all the other stations we're on.
Yeah.
You want to speak in numbers, like when you pretend there's five and there's only two, you fucking phonies?
Yeah, how about that?
How about those numbers, you silly geese?
Inflated numbers of the people just sitting in your studio.
More lies from radio guys. That rhymes, yes.
I like that. It's a good rhyme.
Time. It's one of those guys from that stupid cable show. They're putting their people out now.
Yeah.
Why are they so concerned with us?
We must be bothering them and getting on their mind.
Well, we have more listeners than they do. Yeah. I looked at the numbers on XM, and if every damn satellite receiver that XM owns was on them,
all
they'd
at
have
the
about
same time.
Half as many listeners as we do.
It's kind of pathetic.
Really?
I don't know why we bother them.
Did
so
you know
much?
How much money they
That's
paid
That's a woman.
Them?
That's him.
To do that filthy stuff and have listeners like that brain-dead jackass right there?
We, of course, got a delay because anytime you people want to say something nasty and filthy, we got to tell...
cut it right out.
Tell Roland in there, all these people that's like, says, love ya, people that just... It's probably coming from them now. They put the... they don't know we have the delay, I guess.
They got another one.
You got to look at it as a compliment. Apparently, this little old show down here just getting into their face with it. Idiots.
And make my rump red.
Anyway, guys, I want to tell you this.
Too many cooks spoil the kitchen. That's a good one, Kenny.
The broth.
You fucking lumberjack.
They spoil the broth.
Yeah. What a couple of complete assholes.
But by the way, if 20 minutes into the assault, you're already trying reverse psychology, you're fucking finished.
Isn't it great? Because we've seen this before, like, so many times. We've seen what happens, how they react to it. And it's like, oh, okay, they're already at this phase.
Jesus, that's
boy.
That's usually 4 days in.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we got under the skin. Yeah. Like, we're supposed to go, well, we can't show them that. Call it off quick.
Yeah. Oh, boy. Wow. This little old show.
That's such rubes.
So, and wait a minute. XM has how many on the platform?
Every receiver.
Almost 7 million.
So you take 7 million and double it.
14 million.
So they're saying they have 14 million listeners?
Yes.
Yeah, more lies from a radio
guy. They have 14 million listeners.
Wow.
That's a lot of listeners. They're good.
Wow. Getting into their face with it, idiots. These were the guys. I want to tell you this. Don't do it right. Idiots. Freaking idiots. God. These guys that had that thought it would be funny if they had a couple go down, have sex, and desecrate the St. Patrick's Cathedral of New York City, the oldest cathedral, second oldest cathedral in America.
I don't know about the rest of it. I did not see humor in it. I didn't get it.
That's funny. That's some funny stuff.
Yep.
All right. Thank you, man.
What did you desecrate?
Appreciate your call, buddy.
You're the same guy doing a lot of voices. You're the same guy who lies to his listeners, and you're doing a lot of voices.
Yeah, thank God they have that delay, because how many times would they get called out on it? Just eat up their delay. Just eat their delay up.
How stupid was the Sex with Sam thing? They know who we are.
Yeah, of course they do.
I've never heard one thing they did. And that Barry Manilow song is going to stick in my fucking head now all day. I want to shoot myself.
I know. I got bone marrow cancer from listening to that. And I'm grateful. Fucking suck.
Oh, no.
Let's go
horrible.
To let's go to Casper, Nevada. Casper.
Roger.
Hey, how you getting?
Hey.
I've been I was the Johnny guy on fucking on that goddamn show. I called him up and
you dopey fuck.
Yeah, Johnny. Oh yeah.
Hey Johnny. Oh Johnny.
Dude, I fucked up. I never called a radio show before, so I've been a long time listener for you guys. Love the show.
You did a good job getting in. It's just, dude, remember your fake voice next time.
Dude, what did you say that they jumped tape downs out of? What did you say?
I told him what happened was I said, oh, I guys love the show, and then I yelled, hey, Ramon, you pieces of shit.
Yeah, did Ramon.
Wait till they fucking have Ramon calls coming in.
Ramon.
Who's this, Ramon?
Hey, love you guys.
Thanks, man.
All right, Casper.
Bye, Brian. Brian from New York is checking in. ManCow apparently supporting these guys. He just put out a press release that Walton and Johnson have between 1 and 20 million listeners. Yeah. Somewhere in there. 14 million.
God, what
those
tools.
Guys are using Howie math.
Filthy stuff. They can't even attempt to accuse you of that when they're having five-year-olds curse and have sex.
My goodness.
Or, you know, they're acting
they get paid to do that
scene.
Filthy stuff.
All right.
Shut up.
Jeff in Illinois.
Hey, my boys. How you doing? Hey, guys. The main thing here, it doesn't matter what they're doing. We've got them off their game. We've got them.
Yep.
And that's the best part about hearing them bitch and moan about, oh, you guys did sex for Sam. Oh, crap. What are we going to do? They're losers.
We're laughing at them.
We're laughing.
We're playing their bits and laughing at how awful they are.
We're slapping around like you slap around a new puppy.
That's right. The way you take your cock out and smack an eight-year-old. I mean,
It's genius. We've got them. Good show, fellas.
That's a lot of filth we don't appreciate.
Let's go to Lee the Trucker. Lee?
Yes, I just want to let you all know that Harris County's population, which is Houston, Texas, is only 3.5 million, and they're saying they got 14 million listeners.
That's right.
That's ridiculous.
Brilliant.
Everybody listens twice. They run from radio to radio enjoying the laughs.
Even if they had 10% of all of Houston listening, which would be, I would guess, impossible, that would be 350,000 people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, even if the FM, you know, reached out to the other counties, you know, surrounding Harris County.
Right.
We absolutely have
we all know that. Our listeners are smart enough to know that now. These radio guys just love to lie.
They tell fibs.
And blow themselves up.
We have more listeners than Hannity and Rush combined.
That's right.
Right. All right, punch it out, y'all.
All right. Let's go to Mike in New York. Mike, what's up?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, Mike.
Yo, you guys got me so psyched for the show the next few days. These guys down there in Texas have no idea.
Thank you.
You guys are at your
we
best.
We love a good
and
battle.
And we're going to hit it tomorrow on Terrestrial 2. We're going to hit it both, and you know, obviously everything we do on Terrestrial is heard on XM, so we're going to hit it tomorrow, too.
By the way, the population of Texas is 22.8 million.
So they have almost the entire population of Texas.
Of the state of Texas. They have 75% of the state of Texas.
All right.
Thanks,
yeah,
buddy.
Yeah, they, wow, they probably have about 80 million people calling the station, though, this morning,
some
man.
Signal.
You guys are awesome.
Yeah, they're really getting smashed, and they know it. Well, it must have gotten their head, those dirty boys up north.
Yeah, we got more listeners than they got all the dirty mamas.
Yeah, we got more listeners than they got corn cobs on
there. God damn.
Well, we're just simple
more
folk.
Listeners this morning than they ever did before.
Hell yeah. Yeah, it gets worse from here. Thanks, sir. All right.
Godspeed.
Hell, I'd like you to come to my house and fuck my sister.
Let's say hi to Dugout Doug. Doug, you got to make it fast. We're very busy today. Of course, he's one of the big O&A pests
for
the new listeners out there. What's up, Doug?
I want to give some information that the pest attack is indeed on with the Johnson and Johnson show in Houston.
Or Walton and Johnson.
Walton and Johnson.
It doesn't matter, but let me tell you, they are expecting us, so we need large numbers. We need as many pests as we can to join in. They started their show this morning with a sound bite of our little Jimmy Norton. So they're taunting us. They're calling us out.
What was
they
the sound
task
bite?
You.
What sound bite?
Yeah.
Gotta be creative. It's from, I believe, Lucky Louie show.
Okay.
Huh. Where Jimmy demonstrates the sound effects of performing an act on Use Your Imagination.
All right, very
good. Good.
So they're going to make fun of us by playing a clip from Jim Norton's HBO show.
Good.
Indeed.
Keep playing it, you hillbillies. Keep playing it, you stupid, phony, one guy doing all the voices, hicks. They're phonies. One guy does all the voices. He lies to his listeners.
Yeah, this is something we've been developing on the XM Satellite Radio show. But basically, this show in Houston, you know, kind of talked bad about Bill Burr behind his back after he left the studio, and then
and
we
only
find
we
out,
can do that.
Then we found out that Jim Norton had a bad vibe when he went into their studio.
Terrible.
And then it turns out it's like two guys, and one guy does like three voices. And if you go on the show, you got to make believe that the guy's not doing three different voices.
Yeah, like all of a sudden a girl will start talking, but the guy—it's just the guy doing a bad girl voice. And you're supposed to sit there and talk to him like the girl just talked, instead of going, "Dude, what? Why are you doing that?"
So you're supposed to interact you know, all of a sudden, if you heard a woman's voice right now, I have to go, well, listen, sweetie.
Yeah.
I'm going to go in there and interact with you because you're a fraud with your listeners.
And
you
do some
douche.
Kind of improv garbage.
Ugh. They're two stupid old men.
So Bill Burr kind of called them out on our show.
Yeah.
And then I guess now they're attacking or they're, I don't know what they're doing, actually.
Cute.
So, Doug, what do you need the pest to do?
All right, since we can't give out any other website, I have kind of figured out that we can give out a MySpace with information on how to attack. Do you think that would be allowed?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, the MySpace.com/OpieAndAnthonyPests.
Opie and Anthony Pests?
Opie and A-N-D, Opie and Anthony Pests.
With
right.
It? All right, very good.
All
on
one
there,
word.
All the information on how to contact the Johnson & Johnson show.
Yeah, a lot of people decided to take Friday off just to mess with these guys in Houston today. So give us an update later on in the show, Doug.
Yeah, we've got a Pal Talk room open. We're already streaming, recording, and you guys should have some audio by the XM show.
All right, thank
thanks,
you, sir.
Man.
Party on, Wayne.
Congrats to the pests for making another Forbes article.
Yeah, what was that about?
That guy. What the hell's his name?
We rattled him.
We really ripped him because he gave us some crap. In one of his first articles that he wrote about the show,
yeah,
and XM in general, and then I guess the pests unloaded on him. So the second article he wrote, he mentioned, "Hey, and before O&A's pests just start, you know, firebombing my Greg Levine, that's his name. Before the pests start, you know, just flaming my email box." This isn't about O&A or some kind of defensive posture he took.
Yeah, before he said what he had to say.
Yeah, because he knew the first time the pest just, like, nailed him.
Yeah.
And then yesterday he was, I guess, nominating me for chief marketing officer of XM because I'm always online and always, you know, chatting and on various electronic medium on the computer with all our listeners. And the pests are always stickering stuff and making pests of themselves and getting the word out there. So he was nominating me and the pests for a chief marketing officer. And it's funny until you realize, oh, my God, this is in Forbes magazine. This guy's writing for Forbes and addressing the pests.
Well, the guy really did kind of start with the show for no reason. I mean, nobody ever, we didn't know who the guy was.
But he's coming around.
Yeah.
He's coming around. I think he's starting to appreciate what it's all about. Like through the first hatred and bashing of us, he kind of did a little more looking into what goes on this show and you know, he's kind of warming up to it.
Well, instead of, you know, being lazy, he's doing his own research. Because a lot of these reporters out there, they're just lazy. Oh, they're Howard Stern ripoffs. And then we challenge these people on that. Like, oh, really? Do you know we do this, 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 which is completely different than any other radio show out there? And then you kind of turn them if they're willing to listen and do some research.
Yeah, give a little listen.
Like yesterday, we did an interview with the Boston Globe. And this guy's in a pretty big position. He's writing for the Boston Globe, and it seemed like he didn't even know much about us.
I know. He's doing, like, the Sunday Magazine or something.
Ooh. And I'm like, how does a reporter get away with that?
He said, yeah, I used to listen to you guys. I was like, oh, yeah? And I figured in Boston? No.
No, at NEW.
NEW in New York.
And you guys were really, really good, and then I got really busy with my career, so I haven't heard you in a while. I'm like,
like, okay.
Oh, great. Great. I'm sure this article will be very, very accurate and up-to-date.
Because in order to get, like, an up-to-date, kind of accurate interview of us, you got to know what's been going on in the last, you know, at least two, 3 months.
Right.
That's when a lot of stuff's been happening to this show. Syndication, back to, you know, broadcast radio. And, no, not really much of a clue.
I call you Anthony, and then in quotes, Greg Cumia.
Guys, let's go to General Bam. We got to get in.
Oh, and a pest.
Oh, the general. Update here. General Bam.
Hey, tax going well. We got a whole bunch of pests that have gotten through so well. And they are now back to attacking Bill Burr again.
Oh, good. Let them.
Why would they do that?
I'll tell you why. They're too fucking southern.
Wait, hold on. Catch me up. These are the guys in Houston that were...
Yes. Johnson and Walters.
Okay, okay. I'm sorry.
They're trying to... these are two fucking douchebag, middle-aged nothings.
Phony.
They're phonies, and they're trying to salvage their dignity because they're having their fucking balls kicked in. You're having your fucking balls kicked in by our fans, you dummies.
Can I ask you a question to all you guys? Why you guys... I don't want you guys to get upset with me, but these guys are... on the radar with you guys. They're not even in your fucking
world. We don't care.
No, we don't do it for that.
We don't mind that.
When they bash our pals.
Yeah, we do it for sport.
Like nice. Bill Burr.
They douched Bill Burr pretty good. He said he didn't have a good appearance. I was on their show. I didn't have a good appearance.
Yeah. Well, I could see that, but...
Yeah, no, I was doing my impersonation. I do some good ones. I do the De Niro. I was like, hey, you're talking to me. I couldn't believe it didn't go over.
You'd think it was the real people.
But Bill Burr, when he left, he found out they were trashing him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So Bill fucking smashed him, and I smashed him, too, because there's two white guys. One of them does three voices. A black guy... his own voice, a gay character, and a lady. And you're told when you go in, don't acknowledge that he's doing different voices.
Oh, that's natural. That's real.
Yeah, exactly.
That makes it comfortable for a comic to just do his stuff.
Be himself and be real.
When all of a sudden you have to acknowledge that a man just changed his voice and he's being a
different contrived
person.
Bit.
Do I acknowledge you as the character? We all talk in our real voices here, and this is what you get used to, is fucking interacting like this. So these fucking hillbillies that want fucking a phony bitch thrown at you like you're conversationally just being funny about planes... Fucking douche Bill, and they stunk. I stunk when I was on their show, too, and I'll never be shy to tell you I stunk. But the vibe in that dump was awful. So they fucking said, well, we got more listeners than O&A. You know, because we trashed them.
Right.
And so the pests are now showing them, you don't, motherfucker.
Well, the pests will eat them up. I know that much.
Oh,
yeah.
So, bam, they're back to attacking Bill Burr.
Yeah, they're back to attacking Bill Burr. And listen to their two ingenious ways of dealing with the pests.
All right.
Number one is that they have decided that instead of taking a lot of phone calls today, they are playing pre-recorded bits that guy with the multiple voices records with himself.
You know what? Let me tell you something right there before you go on. I love when the pests make the shows change their show. they force them to change their game plan for the day.
We have not gotten one... Excuse me, Bam. We have not gotten one... Walton and Johnson fan call, whatever the fuck their names are.
No.
And our show has not changed in iota. No. And the fucking, and Bam and Doug and these guys changed the nature of the show. What else are you saying, sweet angel?
The other thing is they've had like 7 real callers get through, and we figured it out that 6 of them are the same person.
Oh, Jesus. Again.
Isn't that great?
Do you have all this taped?
Yeah, we need to hear the audio.
Yes. We have everything taped.
Fuck those
ship
hacks.
Ship some of the successful attacks over to Steve.
And also, we want to hear some of this stuff.
Dude, if you could put those...
I'll punch this off a 100% over.
Hey, Bam, if you guys could put those seven calls back to back of their listeners, the different listeners calling it would be funny to hear the same guy calling over and over.
Yeah. Absolutely. And if anyone wants updates on stuff, it's myspace.com/ Opie and Anthony Pest. That's
Pests.
A new MySpace account.
P-E-S-T-S, because a lot of people saying, hey, man, I can't, I don't know, I can't find that.
Pests. Plural.
Yeah, plural.
Yeah.
All
right. And Anthony Pests.
General Bam, thank you.
Thank you, sweetie.
The bye-bye. General.
You're a good boy.
Right. He's like one of the head guys.
Oh, he's a mess.
We got, audio coming in as we speak here. Pests. We'll have it soon. Swami Opie from Pal Talk, yes.
Swami.
Yeah. Swami. Hey. How you doing, boys?
Howdy.
Hey.
Lovely.
This is Swami Opie. I got, you can tell because my voice is really weird because I got small balls.
Nice. Very uncomfortable pause right now.
That was the type of bomb. That joke died so horribly, nobody realized the punchline had come. If it wasn't for the air, we would have thought he was setting up a serious statement.
Yeah. Just nothing. Dude.
Do you have the clip of
Swami? Dude, there's no way to salvage this. Unless you Bud Dwyer yourself right now. That's the only way to salvage this call.
Swami.
I'm so embarrassed.
Don't be a goose.
So what do you got?
No, I thought you guys had the clip. That's why I was calling, because I figured you'd play the clip.
You're the guy that did the ELO call?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm the
only
guy.
Only took
did
2 minutes
ELO
to get
call.
To what you wanted to talk about. That's,
Jiminy Chris.
That's good for a talk show.
I'm sorry.
So you did the ELO call to Walton and John. Do I need you at this point?
Excuse me?
You're on.
Oh, goodbye. He's thinking of me.
No, well, hey. Look, he's a good boy. He did the ELO call.
Swami Opie, what's your name on Pal Talk?
Swami Opie, I'm on.
All right, I am banning you.
No, don't ban this boy. He did a fine call for us. He's a little nervous.
Where the hell is he?
I'm nervous, and my phone is not loud enough. I'm having a hard time hearing you.
That's all right. You're excused because you got an ELO call through to that fantastic radio show.
And we still don't know what the call was about.
I thought you had the clip ready. That's why I was calling. I didn't.
See, it's your fault, Opie.
Tonight Show?
It's your fault, OPC.
We had the clip ready, yeah.
Basically, he called his ELO and said that he had a strip club named Ramon.
Let's hear the call. We don't have it yet, right?
We don't have it yet.
Okay.
Call back, Swami.
Oh, man, I'm sorry.
Nah, don't be.
I'm right. Popping this guy's video. Here he is. Look at him. Look at him on the phone.
I'm looking at you, Swami Opie. You look like a dick.
You look like, he looks like fucking, he looks like E-Rock.
He does look like E-Rock.
You look like
Holy
E-Rock.
Shit. An E-Rock clone.
He's stupid.
But I should fuck him or fight him.
Fuck him or fight him.
Best part of Raging Bull is Tommy Cuomo laughing like it was the fucking greatest thing he's ever heard. Fuck him or fight him. Couldn't believe Jake had just come out with that gem. Got his arm around him, big thick glasses. Jesus, he covers his mouth. He can't get over it. But Jake said something with the ladies at the table.
Mark in Houston.
Yeah, y'all are killing that show. And also, I saw Bill Burr at the Improv, and he killed.
Of course he
did. There were a lot of pests there, and I mean, he just killed.
Bill Burr's hysterical.
He is a very funny dude.
What are Walton and Johnson doing that they're getting killed by the pests?
They're just mainly playing these stupid, awful recorded songs from... They're like these awful, just parody songs.
We heard a few yesterday.
Yep.
They're horrid.
They shuck.
The day of the song parody, like...
Thank you, sir.
Like, the day of the fucking song parody in radio is really over. It has to be really good... Or very few and far between, and has to be like a special occasion kind of thing. Or,
we'll play one every once in a while.
Yeah, every but as far as like every event, because remember the days of radio where everything that happened, there would be a fucking, you know, Gaza Strip parody that would be on every radio show.
Right.
There were services that would just put out song parodies, and stations all over the country would subscribe to the service and parodies would fly out at all of them, and they'd play them every day.
And all these morning shows would play like they came up with it.
Yeah.
What a crime that shit is.
And it all came from a service.
We try to give people credit every single moment on the show. We don't want to give you too much credit, then it'll prove that we actually don't do anything ourselves.
Not a thing. Not a thing.
We got Walton commentary. And Johnson pest calls.
Oh.
Here's the first one.
This is a list you don't want to be number one on.
Yeah, this is the worst. This is getting close.
Margaret Cho. Or is it Chow? Cho?
Margaret Cho.
Cho. And number one is Bill Burr. I never heard. Who is that?
Never heard of him.
Never heard of the guy.
But he's number one on the Maxim list.
You're damn right.
That's pretty powerful stuff.
That is indeed powerful stuff.
Powerful stuff.
That's all they
what is,
got.
You know
that?
What else is number? You know what else is powerful? You faggot doing a lady's voice and that other fucking sham pretending it's a lady he's talking to.
Can you believe they?
What an embarrassment!
Wait a minute.
Horrid.
That's all
lady.
They have. Really?
They stink.
And that was bashing Bill.
I think Maxim came out with a list of the worst comedians out there.
Yeah. Am I on it?
And I don't think Bill Burr's even on the list, so that was their way of taking a shot at him.
Can you get the list up, Dan? Is that possible?
Bill
can we try
Burr,
to find it?
Can we get who your fingers is this cut guy? Off? I'll do it then. Who is this guy? Isn't that funny? We attack, and the pests attack, and all they do is mention Bill Burr and how bad he is.
Yeah, they sent an email back to Bill Burr, back to some girl. We're not going to mention those guys, it really.
Oh, is that it?
You fucking phonies.
Watch.
Yeah, you will.
Watch and wait, my friend. Everyone caves.
This is great. I love these calls. Any means well. Dave in Richmond, go ahead.
Hey, aren't you guys increasing their market share? I don't have a degree in radio or anything, but increasing their market share because everybody's turning over to them.
We don't care.
You know,
like
you're doing?
Maybe, but you know what? We never play that game because we have enough confidence. It's like if you think that's funnier than this show,
goodbye.
Then we don't want you anyway. Like,
then goodbye.
Beat it. Go listen.
And they get attention for who knows how long this one's going to take, and then they go away. They go back into obscurity.
They buy that old shit. You don't want to talk about the competition. We don't give a fuck. Go ahead. Well, listen good. To that direct.
Drive them into the ground.
Thanks, buddy.
Him.
All right. Well,
they
we,
suck.
Well, we do have the list of worst comedians.
I hate that dishonesty.
According to Maxim magazine, in 12th place. Oh no.
Let's just do the top 10.
Yeah. Why don't we do the top 11? Because
you don't want to do all of them. The dozen. The even dozen.
Nah, I like top 10.
Wow. Christopher Titus definitely looks like Bill Burr in that picture.
They called
I got
him
scared.
One of the worst.
Yeah, 11.
You know what?
Wow.
Here's
those
Titus
dummies.
No, we have to do the list. It was a top 12 list, which is a little strange. In 12th place was Carlos Mencia. 11 was Chris Titus.
Chris Titus fucking talks about his family, his mother's suicide.
Oh, we had him
he's
on.
Fucking, the guy does nothing but talk about there. Real shit. Whether you like him or not, he's not a hack. He's not in the top 12 worst comics. It's ridiculous.
10th place, Judy Tenuta.
I don't know.
How about the irrelevant list?
Ninth place,
Jesus.
Yes.
I haven't even
I
heard of her.
I hate Kathy Griffin.
I disagree with that, too. I think she's also a funny storyteller.
That's fine. I just can't.
If the story is her being raped.
Oh, yeah. That's hot.
Number 8 is Gallagher and Gallagher 2.
Okay.
Oh.
Yeah.
Double shot.
Let's see what's missing from this. Let's see what's missing from this list.
Is Paula Poundstone.
Now, let's see what's conspicuously missing mm-hmm. from the list. Go ahead. Is it?
I'm waiting for its updates. Now everyone else is checking it out. Number 6, man, they hate the female comic. Sandra Bernhardt.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Number 5. Well, Louis Anderson.
Yeah.
That's why I started laughing.
Another guy who talked about his life and his family.
Louis. Just being honest about how awful my life was.
This list is funny. Yakov Smirnov. Just seeing his face and
what
seeing his
a
name
country.
All right, there's your first Schwoogie. Number 3, Whoopi Goldberg.
Whoopi.
So I know that's what you were getting at, Jimmy.
Yeah.
Number 2. Margaret Cho.
Good.
Or Chow.
That was funny when the guy said that.
Number 1 is Bill Burr.
No.
See, I was.
Who do you think is number 1?
Number 1, worst comic ever?
Don't.
I know who it is.
Oh, is it worst comic ever?
You really knew?
It's worst comic ever, right?
Let me think. Oh, don't tell me they're going to go for fucking Carrot Top. Don't tell me they're going to go after him. All right.
Got to be. Black guy.
Did you say?
No.
Well, just tell me what color he is.
By saying, did you see? I think I gave it away.
Oh, black guy?
Yeah.
The worst comic ever is a black...
Did you see it?
Richard Pryor.
Is he black? Let me guess.
Yeah, I saw.
Worst comic ever is a black guy.
He's
20,000 people emailing
okay.
me.
Okay.
Instant feedback.
Let's just put it this way. He's blacker than Sam.
But barely.
Well, don't tell me they're going to say, oh, Jesus, that narrows it down. Owen Wilson. No, blacker than he's black.
Ho ho, Swami, you'll get this one. It's a sin he's so bad. Ho ho, it's a sin he's so bad. A pencil.
A sin he's so bad.
Yeah.
It's a sin.
Right.
Sin is the preacher, reverend.
Yep, yep. You're there.
It's not Cedric.
Work it out.
Not Bernie Mac.
You're kidding, right?
Work it out.
Dead serious. Oh, my God. It's a sin.
No, he's not this stupid.
Come on,
we all know he's not.
I am.
Stop it. He is not.
I swear to God.
You never know with Jimmy, though.
No, no. I know with Jimmy. Jimmy is a smart guy.
I honestly got him stumped. Wait,
no, you're not.
What was your hint again?
I said, it's a sin he's so bad.
Oh, I didn't catch it. The wordplay. Okay. Why would they say he's the worst? Sinbad's not the worst comic ever. He's just...
Worst comedians of all time.
Of all time. Of all time. Even the court jesters were in the running.
Even the open micers.
Open micers, everybody.
Sinbad.
Twitchell's beat out Sinbad?
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah. Pest attacks don't work. Tom.
Hey, did you guys try that pest stuff with Howard Stern? He just fucking ignored you like you're a bunch of little kids. It didn't work, did it? But you never brought it up because it didn't fucking work, did it?
What pest attack are you talking about, Tom?
You're straight. When Howard Stern started talking shit about you when he first went to Sirius, you're like, oh, we're going to call his show and we're going to make him stop. He just fucking ignored you.
Tom, the truth of the matter is...
Tom, he did not ignore
us. The truth of the matter is that the calls are so screened over there that it's very hard to get on the air, and then they dump.
Hey, Tom, let him finish.
And then they dump out of the callers that are against his show and the pests, and you never hear him on the air. Doesn't mean they didn't get through. Doesn't mean it doesn't bug the shit out of him and the screeners that the pests are getting through. He doesn't talk about us because we're a threat. That's what happens.
Now what, Tom?
Or maybe he's just fucking ignoring you, like you're a bunch of crazy broads.
Why would you ignore that?
Also, Tom, how come he didn't ignore us when we were off the air? He talked about us a lot. When we got back on the air and could defend ourselves, then he really didn't talk about us too much. He still did, but why would he do that?
And he's still talking about us. He just hasn't done a live radio show in 2 to 3 weeks.
Maybe if he was on live, he would actually say something. But
so, Tom, answer Anthony's question.
Yeah, Tom,
why is that?
Why, when we were off the air, when we got fired, did he talk about us a lot? And then right when we get back on the air, he shuts up unless he was threatened.
Maybe he's trying to piss you off.
That's your answer, dude?
That would piss us off. We're doing a great show. A lot of people
apparently,
are listening to it. We have we have more listeners than he does.
Tom,
what's your point?
We have a bigger audience than Howard Stern. How does that make you feel?
I don't give a shit about either one of you.
Yeah, you do. You're listening to him,
and you're calling the show, little bitch. Just answer the question honestly.
The people that really don't give a shit about Opie and Anthony, guess what? They're not listening.
They don't give a shit.
They don't give a shit. You're calling our show. You give a shit on some level.
Opie asked you a question. How does it make you feel, sweetie?
Makes me feel great. Hey, what's going to happen when that shit in Houston? When the pests can't do nothing to them? When you just get fucking ignored like some crazy bro?
Dude, why the phony laugh and why the same statement over and over? Yeah. Stop with the phony laugh because you're uncomfortable. Makes you sound like a little faggot. Just talk honestly.
Yeah, I'm real uncomfortable talking to you, Jimmy, yeah.
Yeah, you sound uncomfortable. How do you know my name if you don't listen to the show?
Right.
How do you know who's who by voice if you don't listen to the show?
You're
dishonest, man. You're a mumbling, dishonest douchebag.
Yeah.
And that's what's annoying me about you.
Tom, have a good weekend, all right?
All right, you too.
Yeah.
Good. Take care, Tommy boy.
Maybe Howard will finally be live on Monday. You'll have something to listen to.
Yeah, be a good boy. Just keep listening.
All right, we got some pest, the second pest attack. The Paula Poundstone, they said you got to read the caption under her name. Remember that time Paula Poundstone was busted for getting shit-faced and driving her kids to an ice cream parlor? That's by far the funniest thing she's ever done.
I don't know. Wasn't there an episode where there may have been accusations of inappropriate touching?
Oh, yeah.
With a minor? I think that's the funniest thing.
The kid spilled Coke on her cunt and she just went down and lapped it off.
That went away because she had a good lawyer.
Get me a water, boy. One of you boys get me a water.
Oh,
I don't see anyone running. Wow. No one running.
They don't need to run.
Not Fan.
There's been someone running.
Fan, you don't go.
Why not?
Wow. You're paid. Attaboy.
Oh.
Yeah. Thank you.
Child star. On
it. All right, here's the second pest call.
Wait, did that one get
more
through?
More coming. What?
That one we were just listening to. We didn't hear a call yet.
No.
We only heard...
Burr.
No, that one...
That led to the list. They were reading the same list we just read, and they made Bill Burr
number
one.
Yeah, but that wasn't a prank call.
We didn't hear a prank call. They just mentioned it.
Oh, okay. I see what you're saying.
Right.
I'm sorry.
I thought we missed one. All right.
I'm sorry. You're right.
So did I.
You're right.
This is a list you don't want to be number one on.
Yeah, this is the worst. This is getting close.
Margaret Cho.
Uh-oh.
Or is it Chow?
That's the same. Cho. All right.
Number one.
I'd like to apologize to the...
Same track twice.
What was his name that called? We do suck.
No, I might have screwed up.
You don't screw up.
No, I might have screwed up.
Whatever, let it go. It's okay. Let's just redo it.
I really haven't slept in 3 days.
Oh, you're a doll.
You know how...
You have mold on the brain.
No, I think I screwed up. Here's a pest call. I'm sorry.
Oh,
Elo, is that your name?
Elo.
Yeah. Hey, fellas, how you doing?
Elo.
Today?
Elo, you say you run a strip club?
Yeah. I run a strip. I run a strip club out in Houston called Ramones.
Out in Houston. Yeah.
Thanks for calling, Elo.
Good try. Out in Houston.
Good call.
Good try. It worked, you middle-aged faggots.
You got Elo and Ramon on your airwaves, douchebags.
It worked really well, actually.
Wow.
Matt, why don't you do the lady voice? Continue the dishonesty with your listeners. Don't tell the truth about, well, I don't know nothing about that, Massa.
It's genius.
You must be proud to know that you do a radio show with Tootsie.
Yeah. Two fucking frauds sitting in a room pretending you're something you're not.
Tootsie and Al Jolson.
Five of you. It's awful.
Let's go to Mark. Mark.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Listen, why the fuck y'all trash Todd?
Who?
What?
Todd, that fucking guy that just called right now. Is he fucking a Howard Stern listener?
That was Tom.
Tom, sweetie.
Name was Tom.
Yes.
Whatever.
Why do we have to trash him? We didn't trash him.
You guys are a bunch of bitches. Y'all fucking suck.
Mark. Why uses this kind of language?
Mark.
Fucking hack comedian Jim Norton there.
Mark.
And where will he be appearing?
Yeah, Mark, your acting is so bad.
Mark, where will Jimmy be appearing?
Please call. Please.
What do I know?
Now, come on, Mark.
Come on, Mark.
Mark,
give the plug.
We caught you. Now, admit it.
What?
Admit it.
What?
Yeah.
Come on. You're not. You're waiting for us to lay into you so you could go, I love you guys.
Yeah, come on. We got you.
Yeah,
come on.
You're right.
You can tell the real ones from the fake ones, you douchebag.
All right.
Bye,
and that's just it. It's what Ryan from Portland wanted to say. Stern fans have less passion than I can't see the rest. But that's how we can figure out who's fake and who's real. Because the guys that are fans of our show that are trying to fool us get on, hey, why are you doing this? What? Like, they're all passionate, and this Stern guy's like, you know, you guys suck in Stern rules. There's no passion. They're just so used to doing it. Puppets.
Ryan?
Keep calling.
Yeah.
That's what you were going to say, I guess?
Yes.
Hey, guys?
Yeah.
Have you noticed how the Howard... the real Stern fans have lost the passion the same way Howard has for radio.
Holy cow, they I never noticed that before.
Even the fans just don't have it in them anymore, really.
Yeah, they just don't have it, nothing. Your fans, at least, as goofy as we are, we've got that passion going on.
And our fans are smart.
And they're not goofy,
and
they're
they
all
hear
in
everything
shape.
We say.
What are you going to do when they ignore you?
I'm goofy, and I'm a fan.
You what? You're goofy?
I said, fuck you, Norton. I'm goofy, and I'm a fan, especially of yours, little Jimmy.
Thank you, sweetie.
Aww.
Who isn't?
I'll be in Nashville the 27th through 29th, wink, wink, of this month.
Yeehaw.
And Houston in August. I hope all those Waltman Johnson fans don't show up and have incest in front of me. Douchebags.
Boston Strangler has been waiting on hold for about an hour. Boston Strangler, what's up?
Hey, good morning, boys. I just want to give a little update on our attack on Waltman and Johnson.
Oh, nice.
Now, we have the war room open, so if there are any pests listening, come on over and help support us. Right now, what we know is that Walton and Johnson have not even answered the phones. They will not even let the screeners take phone call because we just completely destroyed their show.
Well, they made fun of the amount of listeners we have, so...
And Bill Burr, a good friend of ours.
And Bill Burr, so let's have at it. Let's see what you guys got.
And they poked fun at my appearance.
Yes, they did.
Very inaccurately.
They did enough that deserved retribution, and now we turn the pests on them, and the pests don't let up.
And what's the MySpace account for the pests? It's MySpace.com/what?
Yeah, what's
www.myspace.com.
Stop! Stop! Hold on. We told you guys.
Right. No more www.
We don't need the www.
We all know it.
We all
ever
know.
Put in, is there another one to put in?
Myspace.com/...
Opie and Anthony Pests.
Opie and Anthony Pests. It's plural.
P-E-S-T-S. And for the new listeners, you can catch up that way. We don't have... well, we do have fans. We have listeners. We also have pests.
Yep.
They're Uber fans. That'll do pretty much anything for the program.
And when somebody does something against the show or people from the show, they attack.
They're animals.
And their attacks are a coordinated effort of all the pests on the phone lines. It pretty much shuts down the show's ability to run like they want to run. They can't take phone calls because everyone they plunk down is one of our pests. And their main volley, their fire that they use, the shells that they put in their guns are... stupid references to this very program, which is hysterical to hear on another show.
My friend,
real inside.
She does stuff for the other satellite company, and she was. I was saw her last night, and she was going, "They're crazy."
Yeah,
are the listeners of the show?
They're creeps and monsters.
Crazy.
Well, all the radio shows have armies. But it's cute, like you get a little patch or something.
Yeah, you got like a sticker or a patch, and you're considered an arm, but you don't care.
You
just,
don't care, you know. You don't do anything. No, our pests live to just wreck people's lives.
That's why we didn't call it an army. They kind of made it up. They were such pests that it just came out.
Yes,
right, right.
I think Jimmy said, you know, they're just pests. Pests just to get under your skin.
And they're
the person at a party that just ruins your time because they won't stop talking to you.
They pester you.
They pester. Pester you.
They don't hurt you. They just pester.
With
excuse
their pestilence.
Excuse me. Yeah. What?
And they took they took it as a compliment, and now they got a huge organization.
The greatest.
Yeah.
That will pretty much eat us alive
eventually
one day.
They will ruin us.
They will ruin us eventually.
They always turn on you.